Hello everyone. I recently cleaned up my camera bag and then I thought this might be a good time to do what's inside my camera bag. Actually, it's kind of funny because in my vlog show you see me carrying around my camera with a big lens and maybe a binocular. But of course, to make these vlogs, I carry around a lot more equipment. Really a lot more equipment. So in this vlog, I'm going to show you what I'm carrying around. And not only to make the photos of the wildlife, but actually also to make my vlogs. So, let's start with my camera bag. So it's a Backlight 36 liters and it's a camera bag from Mindshift. Well, I've been using it for a long time and I actually have a smaller version as well, the 26 liter. It's a great camera bag with a lot of pockets and little things that that make it useful for me as a wildlife photographer. Well, usually on the outside I have some water, there's a rain cover. Well, like all these bags usually have, there are a lot of options to insert extra tripods. So I usually have my vlogging tripod in here, my big tripod, my Benro I have over here. So I think I covered my Benro recently in my vlog about buying a new video head, but in short this is a carbon tripod. It has a leveling base over here and I have the video head from Benro on it, the S6 Pro. But again, I made a full video about this whole setup recently, so be sure to check that video later. Well, there are a few extra pockets over here and there is a bigger pocket over here, and there's an extra laptop sleeve, so there's a lot of options to put extra clothing, maps, my wallet, whatever I would want to over here. But what it's all about is of course in here. So let's have a look. Right. Before I start explaining what's inside my bag, like I already told you, I just reorganized everything. Because over time, I removed things, left things at home, and that's the thing. I noticed that when I want to go out, when I want to go make a movie, I prepare things. If not everything is in one bag and is simply ready to take away, I can, for example, leave at home extra batteries or a spare microphone, or I do not take my drone, and because that all takes time packing. So having one bag ready with all the essential gear for me really works best. Like I explained, I do have a drone. This is the Mavic Mini 2. Oh, I really love how it adds cinematic quality to my vlogs. As you guys probably know, I really always do my best to make nice videos, and a drone is really a big help. So, the Mavic Mini 2. Over here I have two pockets with a remote controller. This is the spare battery pack. You can buy only the Mavic Mini, but you can also buy the, I think it's called the Fly More Combo. And it also comes with three batteries. Then I have a pouch with a whole lot of gear. Well, like I said, spare batteries, always a good thing. So I have, this is the smaller batteries that are going into the RX10. Mark 3 and now the Mark 4. I also have the bigger batteries that are inside my A7R4 and over there in my vlogging camera. So I'm having a few of those with me. And then on the other side I have all kinds of extra accessories. Well, I have a bunch of screws adapting from one size to the other, so I can attach all kind of equipment to my cameras. But I also have other things like a remote control, if I want to remote control my camera. And also one big reminder to always remove plugs from my camera. So this plug has been inside one of my cameras that I put in my car when I went home, and when I returned, the whole plug was bent. So this is just a reminder to myself not to be lazy. I was lucky because it only damaged my plug, and the camera is still okay. Another thing, it's how do you call it, a lens cleaner. So this is for me preventing to do things like and then wiping lenses clean. This is the proper way. It even has a brush to clean out camera gear. And that's also when going away, for example, to the beach. Something like this is really, really handy, or I should say important, to have with me. Well, on the top I have a pocket with all kinds of, it's basically empty, so I can put in whatever I want to. But I usually have something to eat and to drink over there, and a cup, and so that's usually whatever I want to eat and drink during the day. Then I have a whole section which is about audio. This pocket came with my Rode NT-USB. That's the microphone I use for my voiceover. That's at home at my studio. But in here, I have some like extra, how do you call it in English? We call it a rabbit or a dead cat in English. Sure. To prevent the microphone to pick up wind noise, I have an extra Sennheiser lapel mic. As you can see, I'm using a lapel mic over here as well. I usually prefer them, especially for talking, because they are so close to the mouth and there's a lot of noise around me now. Still, I'm practically always carrying the video micro from Rode. It does not need external power. I can simply put it on the camera, plug it in the microphone. And this is the microphone I have been using for my vlogs for a long time. I always have it with me in case I need it. For example, when my lapel mic, these mics are out of battery. But I will return to that one in a bit. I have another microphone from Rode. This is the VideoMic NTG. This is powered, but it has an internal battery. This is a directional microphone as well, and it really has an awesome sound. And I usually have this one on my A7R4. When I record video with that, it will record the animals as well. Awesome microphone. Now I have really a kind of small pocket over here. It is empty now because I am using that right now, because I am now getting towards my vlogging gear. So that gear is all in use. This is the Rode Wireless Go. This is the transmitter. And on the camera I have the receiver, which is plugged in into the camera. You can see there's a wire, and that wire goes to this microphone. It's a lapel mic, so it's a really small microphone, and that's clipped to my t-shirt right now with the dead cat. And that's also the lapel mic from Rode that they recommend to be used with this set. So for my vlogging camera I'm using the Sony 6600. It's an APS-C camera. It also has one of those bigger Sony batteries, so it lasts for a long time. I've also been using the RX 100, which is a small pocket camera without interchangeable lenses. And I usually use that if I'm somewhere with the family and I do want to be able to vlog, but not carry around too much weight. But for proper vlogging, I really like this camera because it has a bigger sensor. I really like the quality and because I can switch lenses. Right now on the camera, I have one of my favorite lenses, which is a 40mm prime from Sigma. It's a 1.4 and that really gives me, even though I can have it close up when walking, but the background can still be really out of focus because of that 1.4 aperture. But sometimes it is nice to be able to zoom a little bit in and out, especially for making B-roll, or sometimes I need to walk in a specific place. And so I always have the 16 to 55 millimeter G lens, which is a 2.8 aperture lens. Mostly I use the 14mm, but I always carry this lens in case I do need to zoom in a little bit more. A bit of rubber, and this is one of those things that I really like. Well, maybe not this rubber, but what it is made for. If I want to use a 1.4 aperture and a 1/50th shutter time, it's really easy to overexpose the image. So I always use ND filter before the lens, and I have a variable ND filter in front. I have the one from Polar Pro, the Peter McKinnon edition, and this is the 6-9 ND filter, which is on top. I do not always need an ND filter. Having to remove it and put it on again, you know, I'm a vlogger, I don't want to spend too much time on that. For a while back, there was a Kickstarter campaign from Alter, and they made this screw it on the lens, on the filter thread, and it can open and close the ND filter, which is attached. This I can use to remove that device from the filter, because if I switch lenses and I want to use a 2.8 on this, I also have to attach that to this lens. Well, there are a few pockets left over here. There's not really a lot of special things in it. Here I have a cloth to clean lenses, and in case I do need to clean my sensor in the field, I have some swabs and sensor cleaner liquid. And in here I have a few small things like extra bottom plate, which is used with the Manfrotto tripod that I use for my vlogging camera. And I have some tie wraps in case I need to secure something if something is broken. And of course, maybe the most important thing, the big centerpiece, that's my A7R4. And I have now attached my 200 to 600 G lens from Sony. The 200 to 600 gives the range that, I think 90% of what I do with wildlife is being made with this lens. On it I have my A7R4, which still suits me. It is a high megapixel, which gives me a lot of crop factor. Around it I have a small rig case, which saved me a few times. There are a few dents around it, and it allows me to attach all kind of things. As you might notice, I have these connectors for the shoulder strap by Peak Design. That's in here as well. And that's pretty much everything that is in the bag right now. So there's one bit of equipment which is not in here that I do use for vlogging as well. And that's a slider a slider is a device that will just, that is motorized and that will move the vlogging camera. And that is really nice if you put some branches or whatever in the front and the camera moves a bit. That gives a bit of extra cinematic quality. So I have a smaller one, which is about this side from the company MyApps. Yeah, I really need to put it close to other things to really notice the parallax movement effect. I also have bigger rails, and I like those, but because they are so big, it doesn't really feel right to put it in my backpack standard, because they are much bigger than a tripod. So I usually bring those if I really know that I have a use for them, and then I just bring them along. This is my camera bag and all the equipment that I take with me when I make my wildlife photography vlogs. Let me know what you think of this video, and if you want me to do more equipment videos, let me know below. You would make me really happy if you would give it a like, and if you haven't subscribed already, please consider doing so, and then we will see each other again in my next vlog.